Well, the original inspiration was a kind of collision of two separate ideas. I had the two characters who became Renko and Hicks kind of popped into my head one day. I had this idea of two characters who stood entirely antithetically to one another, ethically and morally. I want to tell a kind of an anti-buddy story. They're two people who mistrusted each other with profoundly good reason, but who were forced by circumstance to become at least allies. And we knew they were never going to fall in love. We knew they were never going to be friends. But what we wanted to see was to see them trust one another and to follow them on that kind of story, which I thought was a kind of relationship we hadn't really seen on TV. So I had the notion of these two people in this relationship, but no sense of the world in which it took place. And then one day at home, I was editing my books, as I do a couple of times a year, kind of pulling books from the shelf and putting them in boxes, ready to go to charity. And I was playing David Bowie's album, Ziggy Stardust and the Spiders from Mars, the first song on which is called 5 Years. And since I was a kid, since I was, I guess, 15 or 16, it's been one of my favourite songs. It's a song in which the narrator, the character Bowie plays in the song, has just learned that the world has got 5 years left. And what in lesser hands could have been kind of maudlin and nihilistic instead becomes a celebration of the moment and a celebration of life. He looks out at kind of London in all its multiplicity and its vastness and all the tall, short people and all the fat, skinny people. And instead of reveling in nihilism, it becomes a kind of joyous and uplifting experience. And as I was listening to the song, putting these books in boxes, I suddenly thought, okay, that's the world. That's the world that Renko and Hicks can live in. So let's put these two characters in that particular kind of fractious, distrustful relationship, and let's put them in a world that's got 5 years left.